Have you ever wondered like what it's like running a business or being in the same room in like a big meeting and what really goes on, you know? That's why I decided to make my series Weekflow. It's a series where I take you behind the scenes into my business. I'm the CEO of a business called Gemflow. I have a team of 45. You know, I bring you behind the scenes to show you like some of the real stuff, you know, the stuff that would help you in your business, or if you're looking to start a business, grow a business. So you kind of get to learn, you know, like how you structure your meetings, you know, what's the best way to manage people? How do you like find suppliers, or how do you work with clients, creating content, marketing, digital marketing, ads, all the kind of stuff that you need to run your business. I show you that in my series called Weekflow. It's right here on YouTube. It's nothing fancy. It's literally me vlogging all week, a real shit of what I'm getting up to. So check it out. It's on my channel right here. And my company is called Gemflow. If you want to know more, the link will also be down below, and hope to see you in the comments in one of my videos. So let me just introduce myself. My name is Sean. I have a company today called Gemflow, where I help social media influencers build their own brands. You know, if you want to see what that's about, the link is in the description. But let me just take you back to kind of like how I got here. You know, it's 2020 now, but 6 years ago, I was working full time. I was actually an accountant. I went to university. I got a degree because, you know, my parents were like, you need to be educated. I always thought like, okay, I did it because that's what they wanted. I went myself and got myself a degree, got myself a job. But you know, I just was not happy. It's not something that I wanted to do. I just didn't like accounting. You know, that wasn't me. I had this entrepreneurship thing that I wanted to start something and see if I can do it. So I decided to leave my job. And as you can imagine, you know, my parents were like, what the hell are you doing? My friends and family, everybody was just like, what are you doing? You have an okay job. Like, why would you do that? I took the risk. Actually, I moved out of my apartment. I moved into this shared house, which was terrible. I used to have two mice in my room that when I used to sleep, they would literally run around and I had nothing I could do. I tried all sorts to like get rid of them. But you know, the point is I sacrificed to essentially trying to do something on my own. So what I did actually do then, I actually created an app called NomNom, which was the first like health and fitness social media app. You know, think Instagram before Instagram became the thing it is today. We started off amazingly well, had like 40,000 users, then Instagram happened, and actually I lost all my users and the business failed. So as you can imagine, I think it was like early 2016, I've left my job, I'm hardly making any money, and the business that I said I was gonna do, you know, big entrepreneurs, I'm gonna change the world, I didn't, essentially, and it failed. My parents were like, we told you so, go get yourself a real job, what are you doing? And my friends were like, yeah, hey, look, you've had your little fun now, you know, get back to what everybody does, get a job, you know, because I stopped hanging out with them, I wasn't gonna get holidays with them because I couldn't afford it. So yeah, everybody was like, you know, and to myself, I was like, shit, like I can't believe like it actually didn't work. I tried everything, you know, but then I realized I made a mistake, and the mistake I had made was in the business itself. So at that time, I tried to build another social network when I could never compete with that, right? Because it's Facebook. Facebook owned Instagram. Like they had 10,000 developers working on one thing, whereas I'm there, me and like a couple of guys are working on like, you know, it's just no comparison. We just cannot compete with them. But I realized it's an opportunity. The opportunity was this. I saw influencers happening before it happened. What I mean by that is that as a social network is going to grow, there's going to be people on there that obviously people follow. So it means they're going to be the people on top that have the most followers, that essentially have the most influence on that platform. So I started to think like, okay, so if you had that influence, what could you do with that? I realized that if you were to launch a brand today, let's say you watching this today, you're going to start a clothing brand. For you to find customers is gonna be the hardest thing for your business. Who is gonna buy your products? Why are they gonna buy your products? And how much are you gonna have to pay in adverts, PR, marketing to then get your product in front of people, right? So they'll buy that stuff off you. So 4 years ago, I was like, okay, so if this influencer that has all this audience wants to then launch a brand and their own product, all these people surely that follow them would be interested in buying this product. So what I'm saying is that all those people would essentially potentially become customers and it would be for free. So, you know, if you watching this today have 1 million followers and you want to launch your clothing brand, you know, it's going to be pretty cool, right? Because when you launch it, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5% of those 1 million followers will convert and actually buy that stuff off you. So 4 years ago, that was the idea. And that's where I started my company that is now Gemflow. And I thought, you know, okay, influencers are going to become big. They're going to need all this support. So I'm going to build the business that supports them. So essentially, we're an agency, And what we do is we help today influencers build their own brands. We do everything you can imagine. So the logo design to like the graphics to manufacturing the products, fulfillment, drop shipping, customer service, app development, content creation, pretty much everything you can imagine, running ads, digital marketing. And the company's like huge today. So to give you a bit of perspective, I guess, of like where I am today, 4 years later, I think the team now is about 45. I have an office in London. I have one in LA. I actually went out there last year a couple of times to build the whole team there, build the office, the warehouse, and the whole setup. And you know, we have clients all over the world. We've launched some amazing brands and products. We had an app like number one on the App Store. You know, I would say at this point in time, I've probably done mostly everything there is to do in business in the past 4 years, from hiring, raising funds, I have a bunch of investors, a board, finding all sorts of different manufacturers, dealing with problems of staff, of clients, learning about digital marketing, running ads, scaling brands, retail partnerships, pretty much everything there is in general, like I would say direct to consumer businesses, I've pretty much gone through. So now, 2020, I've started creating content on my YouTube and Instagram. And you know, as I mentioned in the beginning, one of the reasons really when it comes down to it is that when I was starting out, I used to search for content to be like, I wonder if there's any advice on like, what's the best way to hire? Or how do I source investors? Or what does like monthly recurring revenue really mean? You know, like kind of like the real stuff that you need to know in business. There just wasn't much content on there. And if there was, it was your guy that's like, oh, you know, I help all these businesses buy my course and it's all in there. But if you actually search them, right, they don't have a business. They've never actually done anything, but they have this business telling you how to do it. So, you know, so yeah, it's kind of just like that. That's kind of like my journey and what I was going through when I was trying to learn. So, you know, I've decided to kind of set this up. So hopefully if you're watching this and you're a founder, you want to start a business, you have a business, hopefully some of the content I create will help you. I'm not selling you anything. I'm never going to sell you anything. That is not why I'm doing this. I don't need the money. I'm not doing it for that purpose. It's pretty much, it's fun to talk about my experience and it's fun to have people come back to me with their problems and me trying to help them. So, you know, in my other videos, you know, I've been creating content on my YouTube probably for about a year and a half now, as much as I can. And, you know, I love it. People come to me with real problems like, okay, I'm struggling to find a manufacturer. This is what's happening. They're not telling me like the cost of it. They're not doing this and I'm trying to help them. So yeah, hopefully that was helpful. As I said, you know, at any point, feel free to check out about me. My name is Sean Hanif. Check out my LinkedIn, my company is Gemflow, our clients. I will link it all in the description anyway. But hope you like this video. Give it a thumbs up. You know it helps. And make sure you subscribe. I got a lot of different videos already and lots more coming. And I think a final layer note is I actually have a series called Week Flow, where I show you behind the scenes of what I'm doing in my business. So I literally vlog the whole week and then I put it up. I think it's every Wednesday the new episode comes out. I'm on about episode number 25 now. And gives you a great insight into me, my personality, my team, how I work. And you know, it's literally free. If you love entrepreneurship, I think you'll find it quite cool. So check it out. Let me know what you think. But I hope you like this video and I hope to hear from you soon.